Hi friends! I really hope that your little enjoyed our video on building a volcano. In this video, I'm going to give you simple step-by-step instructions on two different ways to build a volcano in your own home. Let's get started! Every great volcano gets a bit messy in the construction phase. In the video, we used a really simple way to make our paper mache, which was one part glue and one part water. The water will help thin out the glue so that your newspaper easily slides through the mixture. But if you live in an area where you can't buy glue by the gallon, another really simple way to make the paper mache is one part flour to two parts water. Take your trusty whisk and whisk it together. The trick with this paper mache is to make sure you whisk it enough that you don't leave lumps because you don't want your volcano to be lumpy. Once you've decided the type of paper mache you want to use for your volcano, the next supplies you're going to need are a base for your volcano, like an old piece of cardboard, an empty water bottle, a lot of newspaper, depending on how big you want your volcano to be. And then either an old brown paper bag or white computer paper. You're also gonna need something to adhere the bottle to the base. In the video, we used old modeling clay that was getting a little too dry to use for fun. So we simply used that, rolled it out, and stuck it around our bottle. Once you have your bottle fixed to the base, you're going to want to cut about half of your newspaper into strips and save the other half for the bulk of your volcano. To build the inside of the volcano, you're going to crumple up the newspaper, dip it in your paper mache, and simply stick it to the bottle. Once you get your volcano as girthy as you want it to be, then it's time to take your strips of newspaper and run them through the paper mache, making sure to wipe off the excess paper mache and simply stick it on the outside. If you're going to have your kiddos paint the volcano after it's dry, but you don't want to see the newsprint through the paint, you can simply cut up an old brown paper bag or some white computer paper, run that through the paper mache before you start the drying process, and stick it on the outside. That way, when your kiddos attack the volcano with their paint and get really creative, you don't see all of that newsprint underneath. All right, friends, let's talk about my favorite part of the volcanoes, which is the lava. Here are two simple ways to make lava for your volcano. The first is a chemical reaction between vinegar and baking soda. This lava will slowly bubble up to the top of your bottle and ooze its way down your volcano. Here's what you're gonna need. Into your bottle, you're gonna add half a cup of water, 1 tablespoon of dish soap, which will help it foam, a lot of red food coloring, and 2 tablespoons of baking soda. You're gonna wanna set aside 1/4 cup of vinegar. The vinegar is what's gonna cause the chemical reaction when your kiddo pours it into the bottle. The second type of lava is the lava that we made for the video. This is my favorite type of lava to make because it gets really messy. So we used our ingredients for elephant toothpaste from our chemical reaction video. If you would like your lava to be thicker and a little more explosive when it comes out of your volcano, well, make sure you do it outside. But the ingredients you're gonna need are 1/2 cup of hydrogen peroxide. You can use 3% hydrogen peroxide that you get at your local pharmacy. Or if you have a beauty supply shop in your area, you can get a developer. We use developer 30. Which is a 9% hydrogen peroxide, which makes the explosion a little bit bigger and a lot thicker. You're gonna want a generous squirt of dish soap and almost an entire bottle of red food coloring into your bottle inside the Volcano. With this experiment, for some reason, the food coloring tends to lighten up a lot. So if you want deep red lava, as lava actually is, then you're gonna need to add a lot of food coloring. Then you're gonna add together a quarter cup of warm water and one pack of baker's yeast. Once you have that mixed together, you're gonna wanna let it sit for a few minutes and let that yeast really activate. Once that's done, you're gonna pour your yeast mixture into your Volcano and then stand back. This chemical reaction happens really quickly and can get pretty messy. So if you're gonna be inside, I would put a drop cloth down on the floor or just take it outside if you have a place to do it there. Well, that's the end of this video. If you found this video helpful, give us a thumbs up. And if you're gonna make volcanoes with your kiddos this weekend, we would love to see how they turn out. You can tag us on Instagram at Hazel's Mom Official, hashtag official explorer. We would love to join in the fun. And if you have a different way to make paper mache or to make lava, you can leave us a comment below. All right, friends, happy volcano building. Bye.